There I am. Sorry about that. I think I must have had my other microphone on last time. Anyways, hi everybody. Welcome back. Good to be here. Sorry I am a lot later. I'm on a lot later than I thought I was. I promised my wife I'd watch a movie before my stream, and I did not calculate properly. So I was like, okay, cool. So this I'll be done by about 9:30 and I can hop on the stream, and I looked at the clock and was like, did I do my math wrong? So anyways, for those of you who are on and hanging out with me, thank you for joining me, even if it's an hour and then a half an hour later than I said I would. I'll try to stream a bit later, maybe till for like an hour and a half or so. We'll see. Now I did get I'm over 4,000. I'm over 4,000 Theonite. Very excited. Basically, I was close to 4,000, and then Juju was like, "Hey, I sent out the 200 Theonite thing. Let me know if you got it." So I don't know if some of you got that. I think it was a reward for filling out the we sent out a survey in the mail a couple weeks ago, I think. And I think that that mail went out today to thank everybody who filled out the survey. So if you filled out the survey, I think you get 200 Theonite and some canopy coins. So, and thank you to everyone who filled out the survey. It's very, very valuable to us. I think so. I'm pretty positive that's what it was for. I don't remember it saying or mentioning the survey when I read it, so but I'm pretty sure that's what it was for. So anyways, I'm over 4,000, which is what I wanted to do, so I could yet again buy the Special Forces Spotlight Relic voucher. Because second time's a charm, and I'm gonna get that X-Bot. What should you save your Theonites on? That's a great question. It kind of depends on where you're at in the game. If you're still building up your collection, I would save your Theonite for that. The Special Forces, or rather just any Spotlight Relic, any offer that is that says Spotlight Relic is a pretty good value, even for 4,000 diamonds or 4,000 Theonite, because the odds of you getting... You're guaranteed a gold, for one thing. So essentially you can look at this like, for 4,000 Theonite, you're basically buying this gold variant, right? So you might want to save it until, I don't know, I'd imagine that we're gonna have, you know, new characters coming out down the line. I just don't know what those are. So you could say like, all right, I'm gonna save up 4,000 diamonds or Theonite until I'm guaranteed a new variant from the Spotlight Relic. So that's one way to look at it. But honestly, when I first started playing, I always just spent my Theonite on Premier Relics, the 10+1 Premier Relics. So you can do that too. And then some people save their Theonite just for the super mega hyper crazy relic pack, which I don't think I have available to me, but for 10,000 Theonite, and sometimes less than that, sometimes 5,000 Theonite, you can buy the hyper mega variety pack. So every character, what is it? It's 11 or 10. I think it's 10. I don't remember. I think it's 10 or 11 or 13, something like that. Yeah, for 10,000 Theonite, you get like 10 plus one relic vouchers for each character. It's like 180 characters. It's crazy. It's the best deal, but that's like $100-$150 value, something like that. What's up, Hope? Greetings. Thanks for tuning in. I know it's late down there in South America. I think Argentina and like Chile, that's like all, that's like 4 hours ahead, I think. So you're, what, 2 a.m.? Yeah. You were betrayed last time you tried it. 3 a.m., okay. Oh, even further ahead, that's 5 hours ahead. Wow. So I think Chile is 4 hours then. Argentina must be 5 hours. I know. Oh, Argentina's on the coast, right? I always forget. Forgive me. South America map. I know they're close to each other, right? Yeah, Argentina. I knew they were like right next to each other. Chile's on the coast, and then Argentina's on the other coast. So yeah, Chile is, I think, 4 hours ahead. So I guess, and yeah, Argentina goes all the way across, almost. So, depends on what part of Argentina you're in, you might be an hour ahead. Anyways. Hey, Weekend Warrior's good. Weekend Warrior's really good. How's this one? Defense, crit damage, and accuracy. Element bonus, meter gain, special cooldown. Alright. So I think I can buy the special forces relics without actually opening them, right? Yeah, okay, good. Done and done. Getting that X-Bot tonight. No, Argentina was good this year. That was the whole story, right? I was rooting for Croatia. I was rooting for Croatia, and then the U.S. obviously, and then Mexico. I was rooting for, Croatia did okay. Not as good as last time. Alright. Join the Xbox gang. Alright, here we go. Well, let me open some gifts first. Let's see. Butterslin, thank you. Houston Boss and Climax and Juju Blue and Coco and Overdrive. Zug, thank you. Reshram, Sky Bay. Let's go to Ziao. Thank you. Alright, here we go. Whoa. Wow. Awesome. Well done.
Well done. Well done, old chap.
Alright, let's go to X-Flane. Thank you, X-Flane. Oh. What if I got a relic every single time? That'd be cool. Oh geez, the backbone. Canopy coins, thank you. Super Kirby, thank you. As long as I don't get two Rift coins, I'm happy. I just jinxed it. Melon? Okay, not yet. Luis Denny's, thank you. Ike, thank you, Ike. Honest Patches, big Patches.
Evil Gordo, ah. Oh. Evil, evil Gordo.
Alright, Bob. Oh, come on, Bob. Let's go. Thank you, Bob, for the premier relic. Bob flashing that number cruncher. Alright, Baction. Does Baction gift me a gold relic? If you have been on my streams before, you know exactly what we're doing. Yes or no? Do I get a relic?
Right.
Yeah. And then we'll go open these relics with our fingers crossed. You want to get that number cruncher? There's a very few people with number cruncher. That's a tough one. But keep coming to my giveaways. All right.
Heart of the Cards.
Nope. Close though. 10,000 canopy coins. It's not bad. Okay, you all bet wisely. What's up, Alexa? Alexa. So all we have right now is the Sarabella prize fight, which I didn't want to do. But then I was like, you know, I do need to keep collecting the gold fighters so I can evolve them over time, right? So there's always a reason to do them. Shout out. Alexa, turn off the computer. Alexa, play Bon Jovi on Spotify. Hey Alexa, stop. Wow. Oh my God. All right. Here's the funny thing, my Alexa actually activated. I forgot that I even have one. It was a gift. It was a gift to my brother-in-law, and it was like he didn't even want it. He never used it. It just sat in his house, right? So we took it. Like, let's just take it back. He'll never notice. And so we did, and guess what? He never noticed. And so we brought it up to him like later, and he's like, oh, you guys did? Oh, whatever. I don't want that thing. And so we still have it. We just never use it either. That was really funny. So literally, I just heard, playing Bon Jovi. I was like, oh, crap. Because my wife's downstairs trying to get to sleep, so I don't want to be playing Bon Jovi late at night. Oops. My door is closed. I didn't think it, and it's like in the other room, like on the other side of the room. I didn't think it could hear me. Oh, man. All right. Lucifer, how's it going? From Ohio. Yeah. All right. Let's open some relics here. All right. So user channel points, we're gonna gamble away on some relics here. I also claimed my Lovestruck relics from the prize fight, we'll do the Special Forces relics, and I got a couple of other relics too. Cool. How close am I to any of these? Oh, I'm really far away. I'll get rid of these. Oh my! You're from Chile. I have two coworkers of mine. We have two of our Hidden Variable Studios team members are in Chile. They work from Chile. It's really cool. They're from Peru. All right, right on. So we've got some Chileans putting their hard work into Skullgirls Mobile. So you should be proud. Let's see, who are we representing? We've got most of us live here in California. We've got people from Canada, then other side of the country, New York, Tennessee, and then we've got some folks that I think are originally from South Africa, and sometimes are there. And then we've got people in Ireland, and I think that's it. Yeah, and then Chile. Pretty cool, huh? All right. The pandemic opened up a lot of doors to discovering that we can do our jobs, you know, from anywhere in the world. Pretty cool. What's that cup on the screen for? I just thought that was cool. That's something. It's just a little animated thing. So whenever I get a new follower, or a new sub, or bits, it'll drop a little token in the cup. It's like a tip jar. Really, I just think it's fun. Let's gamble here. So we're not really gambling, but we're gonna bet on the shrouded relic. You're gonna use your channel points, your crazy banana points, and we're gonna bet whether I get a bronze or a silver. And I don't have Neuromancer yet, so that'd be cool. Class Cutter I don't have either. Dark Might I just got recently. I still don't think I have Bio Exorcist, actually. I should double check. Heart of Darkness I'd love to get. I think I have Raw Nerve. I don't know if I have Ultraviolet. No, I'm pretty sure. Rogue Agent, that's the one I want. Bones, have you kept up with the webtoon? Any hints to when Ice Cream Truck shows up? I actually haven't. Thanks for reminding me. I need to finish that. All right, here we go. Whew, Heart of the Guards. And I really love reading comics, but lately I've been like all in on just playing all my video games as much as I can. But when I was younger, like going through middle school and high school and college, I'd be like all in on games, and then I would like be all in on like reading comics, and then I would stop and then I'd go back to games. But lately it's been like all games, which is fine because it's my passion. But I do have like a handful of books and comics and stuff I still want to read, so I'm doing my best. What was the point of that? So I was kind of speaking to like how I'm not naturally kind of drawn lately to going and reading comics or books and stuff. But I do have, like, it's one book I'm reading, another book I'm reading, and then I have a couple of comics that I want to catch up on. Alright, including the Skullgirls webtoon. I think I'm like through episode, I think I'm halfway through it. Megasonic's better than Epic Sax? Maybe. I know Epic Sax is good. I know Epic Sax is a good offensive character. Alright, choose outcome. That was a bronze. Come on, guys. We gotta do better than that. Alright, we're gonna open the Sunken Relic next. Sunken Relic? I don't think I have Tidal Traveler. I don't have a lot of these. Tidal Traveler, Material Girl I might have. Lapis Luxury I think I actually do have. I do not have a Heavy Metal. And that's what I want. Biting Cold. I think I actually have a Biting Cold now. We'll see. Silver or better would be ideal. All right. Here we go. Found it yet. I gotta figure this out. This cannot stand. I'm getting all my rolls out. I'm rolling out my ones. Just Kitten, one of the best variants in the game. Pretty tough defender. Let's do our Lovestruck relics. So Lovestruck, we're gonna do silver, or do we have gold or better? All right, which one of these don't I have? You try to roll out your ones for D&D, you have to. Soul Crusher? I think I have Soul Crusher. I got Beast King. Hell yeah. Overclocked. That's what I want. I don't have Overclocked. Did you know? What? You guys are nuts. You got two fireflies. Oh. El Huesos versus El Sin Huesos. I looked that up. It has something to do with bones. Is it bones? Bones and bone, bones and then without bones? You guys are dorks. Alright, here we go. Love Struck Relic. Dashers, dashers. You know it's a silver. Sorry, guys. That is a silver. Alright.
One more time.
You guys listen to Kavinsky? I'm seeing him on Thursday night. All right. Go to Spotify and listen to Kavinsky. He's pretty cool. he plays that opening song on the movie Drive. It's pretty cool. How do you spell him? Kavinsky. So I'm seeing him live on Thursday night as a surprise from my wife. Yeah, my good luck charm. Spend money. Wow, I haven't done this in so long where I have to actually clear out my collection. Damn. Alright, let's do, let's just prestige some bronze. Let's do that, yeah? I know I have a lot of rusties. Yeah. What are the bronzes? Sketchy? Let's do my sketchy, yeah. I still get the prestige, even though it's not. This is a bug, by the way. It's not a bug, but we're gonna adjust it so it's not like, because when you have a character at max and you try to just do prestige, it doesn't quite work, right? It doesn't look good. So I have not unlocked the sketchy's prestige. Let's do one just to make sure it's not actually super busted.
Inside you, it's hard to explain.
toxic film. It's making space. So I still need, like, I think I need to get rid of, like, 10 more shelter. Song requests. I should sort that out at some point. Yeah, maybe. Cause there's a way to do it to where you can just like it's all on you, right? It syncs to my Spotify, and then you can just do it on your end. So I don't have to like manually go and change the song or something. I wonder if it can create like its own playlist. That'd be cool, like a jukebox. That'd be fun. You're at risk though, because if I don't like it, I'll just change the song. But that'd be cool. I should look into that. Oof. Be nothing but. Nothing but Slayer and Cannibal Corpse and all that good stuff. All right. We're going to start a prediction. So now we're going to go back to bronze or silver. All right, here we go. I like watching Kriparian, Hearthstone streamer. He has a really cool setup. So he has those like those colored lights on the back of his wall. Moose Simps, 100 bits, thank you. How goes the relic pulls? Not good. But we're gonna open up a the spotlight relic 10+1 pretty soon here, and I'm pretty confident I'll finally get that X spot. Waste all your points on doubles. Gehenna theme. Alright. oh no. See, that's why I won't do it, oh geez, because you'll just play that song over and over again. No, I was saying Kriparian has like a colored wall, and you can spend channel points to change the colors or do like patterns and stuff. It's really clever. It's a lot of fun. Because he's really chill when he streams. He's just like this. He like barely talks. He's like, Yeah, I think if I do this and this, let's do it. Like, that's all he does. He's, like, really quiet. He's just really focused. So you can just, like, mess with his lights all around him while he's just, like, really, like, into the game. It's really funny. Well, it truly is a late night stream. You're about to go to bed. All right, see you later. If you watch the stream just like this, it's almost like you're on a big screen. And then the sound of my voice will put you to sleep. All right, here we go. That's silver. Freaky Friday, not bad, not bad. Ooh. Loose cannon relic shards. You spent 1,000 gold shards and went out and got yourself an Xbox? Who let you buy an Xbox for 1,000 gold shards? And, you know, how did you even get those out of the game to use them? I thought we fixed that bug. Oops. That's very cool though. Congrats, I'm very jealous. Rub it in. Alright, that was a silver. Nobody bet silver. Wow. Y'all just lost points. So you guys have nothing to bet on because you're too scared to bet on these relics. Because you keep losing. I used to have a... Back when I parked... Back when I parked cars, one of my coworkers was an ex-GameStop employee, and he said that he and his coworkers, he worked in an area where he'd get a lot of like really, really, really wealthy people that would come into his GameStop. So he said he would get like, you know, 10-year-old kids, 8-year-old kids with just like a huge stack of games that they were bringing back. And they were there with, like, their obvious, like, very rich mother or something. And he said they would scan the game, like, cash back for the kid and then, like, scan the next one. But, like, check that in to themselves. Like, add that to their own account. So, essentially, they were stealing from customers. But the people were such brats, they didn't bother to check. I was like, okay. Jeez. So keep an eye on the GameStop employees as they're checking in your games, I guess. I'm guessing they only do it to kids who don't care. All right, here we go. Nope. Pull an X-Bot, I'll give you... That's against the terms of service, Moose. that's a bronze. Well done. How many loose cap? I think I need 10 more loose. Yes, damn it. I need 10 more. There's no more. I need one more Veiled Premier Relic. I'm definitely going to get it. So I think we have Veiled Premier Relics for a bit longer, so. Cool. Alright. Here we go. We're going to open the Special Forces Spotlight Relic. I want to make sure that I have enough. I do. All right, so here's what we're going to do. So you guys are gonna guess, you guys are gonna predict the bonus relic, okay? So the final relic is gonna be either it's a guaranteed gold, right? I think what I usually do is whether I get a dupe or not a dupe. Well, that's a pretty bad bet, because I'm guaranteed the unfazed. Yeah, I can't do nothing with this one. I think last time we did do a shiny. All right, let's do that. It's a terrible bet. You should not do this bet. Spell check. Okay. Here we go. What keybird am I using? I don't even know what this is. I'm using a AZZA Delta. Whoa, you can buy these keyboards are still on sale for $50. That's a lot. This is an old ass keyboard. How funny. It's a good keyboard. This is a used keyboard this person's trying to sell for $50. That's funny. Yeah, I am kind of sick of this keyboard. All right, here we go. Sign. Oh. That's good. I just guaranteed 2 gold black dahlias. No shinies yet. What's up, Glob? Got every Dahlia except for unfazed. Holy cow. No shinies. There's that last unfazed. Damn, man. I was sure of it this time. All right, I've got 12 days to get 4,000 Theonite. No shinies, right? Double check. No shinies. But It's raining. Raining at my house yet again. It's a weird sound coming from outside. Alright, that was no shinies. That's a bummer. Will there be any more opportunities to get Number Cruncher? Yes. Let me double check the giveaway schedule. Looks like on the 10th of March, so a week from this Friday, that March 10th, Juju Blue will be doing a giveaway. It looks like she's doing it on the official Skullgirls TikTok. So if you're not following on TikTok, go follow us, Skullgirls Official. I think it's the one that has like 150,000 followers. And I think she's gonna try it on there again, but I can't say for certain. So just keep an eye out on Twitter and I'll let you know. Glob, I assumed you asked that because you knew how to get Number Cruncher. You can only get Number Cruncher from giveaways, so just keep an eye out for giveaways, and good luck, because you have to win them. Is there a shiny Number Cruncher? Does someone have a shiny Number Cruncher? Is that what you're asking? I think so, and they might be on my friends list. I guess not. I must be thinking of, I'm thinking of, I think Evil Gordo, yeah, has fan favorite. I thought Evil Gordo had a shiny fan favorite. I guess not. I thought somebody had a shiny fan favorite. Guess not. That's a good question. I don't know if anyone has a shiny Number Cruncher. Yeah. Poor Melon. I would say Evo last year was probably when we gave out Number Cruncher the most, but I think we had Number Cruncher available at Anime Expo in Los Angeles last year. That's how, because Ike Zender and Little Puppet came and visited the booth and introduced themselves, and that's how I know they got it. So, July of last year would have been the earliest that we had a public thing that you could get Number Cruncher from. Then we had her at Evo in Vegas. All right, last relic on my list. Good old-fashioned best relics. The premieres. Watch, this is gonna be an X spot. Excuse me. Uninstalling. I think you're uninstalling, Moose. It's even worse. It's a rerun. Alright. Hi, Chihuahua. What do we have going on? Maybe I could do some daily events. Anything I haven't done? Ooh, Days of Future Cats I want to do. Didn't I finish this on Master finally? I did, yes. Holodeck. I've got some plays there. I haven't done Accursed Experiments. I don't feel like doing it on stream. Let's work on Holodeck. That might be kind of fun. On Master? I think I can beat it on Master. Didn't I do it last time? Yeah, I did. Talk about a rerun. Make sure I don't forget to set my deployments. I always forget. Let's skip these. And then let's just do one of these. Got snake bite. I know, I'm starting to see a lot of snake bite buzz more than usual. I've been leveling up model leader though, specifically, so this is kind of like I just run with Lovecrafted, use Killjoy to hopefully keep Lovecrafted alive, and then just keep cranking out XP for model leader. I think this is probably the best strat to quickly is a relative term, quickly level up your diamonds. Which you guys probably already knew. Granted, it's not always super easy to get through these nodes, especially on Master difficulty, but I've been pretty, I'm pretty fortunate to have a pretty good luck of the draw. The opponents I've been getting. Oh, I got her. At the last second. That was funny. And even, like, only at, like, 10.7k, she's already just kicking butt. Possible. Oh no, you don't. Oh no, you don't. Oh my god. Come on, dude. Thank God for that auto block. Thank you. Damn. I knew that the blessing sometimes they do like the fall, like dead animation, so I didn't want to like mess that up. Oops. Alright, I'm gonna like lose though. I'm not doing enough damage. No.
What?
Dude, this isn't good. Just die. Kill her so I can get Squiggly back. Jeez. What the hell, man? Why'd that take so long? Well, I won one. Gotta get those combos up. I know. Damn, dude. Bleeding fast. Oh. Don't you stun me. Eating him alive. Seeing the XP slow down significantly on my model leader here. Now it's like one fight only gets me to one level, maybe less than that. Ugh. Oh, what? Get out of here. I think that's a Beast King, but I can't tell actually. They're both fire types. This Meow shouldn't be too challenging. But That's a number one. I thought that might be it. Yeah. You'll be fine. Yeah. Here's where the real XP comes in. What's this one? This might be enough. That's not the peacock I want to see. Yep. There it is. Idea to switch to Annie, but I need a little bit of heals. Connect? No. There we go. Perfect. Oh. Oh. Oh, I can't tag out yet. Oh no. There we go. Come on, baby. Doesn't burst, right? Okay, good. Whew. How much XP is that? 202,000. This one's usually a lot tougher. This guy's got the heals, but I blocked the heals. Oh crap. Come on, baby. No. Don't you dare. Oh, wow. What? Shoot. What? What is happening?
Whew.
How much XP is that?
$268.
Not bad. Not bad at all.
Alright. I got 4 minutes left. Let's see if I can grind out some of this prize fight here.
And I think the march crake some heads starts tomorrow. Let me double check. Tomorrow. Next event. Prize fight.
Maybe model leader in there soon. You know, I had a diamond key in the shop earlier, and I didn't buy it. I probably should have, no matter what.
Squiggly combo for me. Full ground combo. G5, silver core, G5, dragon bite, G5, dragon drop, and finish with inferno. I've seen that one before. I suppose I could try that at some point.
That's a bounty, so I want maximum puntos. I forgot I was playing for a second. I thought I had auto fight on. God, sometimes the AI is just like randomly incredible.
What's my opinion on brawlers? Grapplers? Are you just saying it like in fighting games in general, like Beowulf?
I just had him on my team, my dragon brawler.
I use him quite a bit. He's a good backup. I like to think of Lovecrafted as my best fighter, but if she goes down, who do I want
having her back?
That's dragon brawler. Usually in fighting games, I like to play big, heavy guys, like big, slow-moving, tough-to-kill, highly defensive, just thick dudes. Ugh.
Excuse me. Yeah, I have a bad hair day. I think I got my bad hair day up to gold. But there's so many characters to use, and I haven't gotten into the game where it's difficult enough to where I need to specifically match particular characters, you know? Like, we're in high-ranking riff battles. You're gonna have to start being real strategic with the signature abilities. Yeah, see, I got my bad hair day. Oh, and mine's shiny. excuse me. Save my energy refills. You know, I don't need to. I've got a lot of diamonds to work on. A lot of fighters to work on. Hearing like noises outside of my house, it's freaking me out. It's raining, so it's like the rain's making a bunch of noise, but then I'm hearing like thuds and stuff. I'm like, what is happening? There's just people on my street just make noise, you know, for no reason. Yeah, I forget, I just spent a bunch of diamond keys, I think, on Model Leader, because she's so amazing. I was like, you know, I really should have her just for defense and stuff. It'd be fun to set up a prize fight defense that's actually like challenging you, right? You know, might get me extra bonus points. Ugh, come on. Diamond is busted. No! Alright. The fact that 10 diamond keys equates to $330. Wow, you did the math on that? Yeah, it might be. I'm curious. Blah, 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 blah. 1.5. Now the rule of thumb is always do the bounties. They are always worth it. Squiggly! Running wide! Cerebella! Can't turn down a fan. But I also don't know for certain. You got a job. Yeah, I think we're brainstorming on ways to assist players in, you know, leveling up their fighters easier. So like, you know, just what are some other systems, even economy wise, that we can help, help players boost their favorite characters faster. But that's further down the road. XP treats. Be cool. The big change I'd like to see, which I think would be really cool, is I think we already did this once recently. We increased the odds of getting a diamond key in cursed experiments, but I still think it needs to be higher than that. I mean, on the extreme side, you should be guaranteed a diamond key for doing a cursed experiments. I think that'd be cool because you only do it once a week. So that could be a nice drip feed, if you will. And then obviously saving your gold and other resources for the COC. You've gotten two.
Oh man.
Well, that definitely needs to be increased. What am I at? Almost 2 million. 1.78. Got a ways to go. Not a bounty. So let's see if I can do this without a bounty. Without my core team.
Time to operate.
Robo Fortune.
Yes, you'd have great luck facing me in versus mode because I'm not as good as I used to be. But I've got a tag out. I've got to practice using tag outs. So I have the achievement. So I never use tag outs. I bet I could crank it out in these early prize fights. Alright, Mexican Apu, see you later. I'm just using tag outs. Didn't quite work. Yep, I block, counter. It's like 90% of my gameplay, and then I'm trying to get better at like timing, like how the AI dashes, and when I can interrupt them better. So I guess I'm getting a bit better at that. Wait, why did I do this one? Was this a bounty? I picked the easiest one for some reason. That was pretty funny. I got like 3 tag outs right there. Show me the tag out thing. Ugh. For my achievement, accolades, combat. I need one more 50 hit combo. I'm like, when did I do a 50 hit combo? I don't remember doing it 9 times. What? Outtake 100 opponents with buffs. What? I had no idea. Okay, so they have to have a buff. I did not know that. Keep that in mind.
Cerebella! Misfortune!
Oof. Excuse me. Comes that battle butt. Oh. Every time. What? Oh, outforded. Joy, not good. Okay, there's one. Die now. Ugh. Just barely, but I'm stunned. Oh my god. Okay. I've got the good shinies. I have no idea. Crumbelina. What's up, Overdrive? And someday I'm just gonna like focus and just do that one tag out accolade and that's it. There it is. Alright, I'm pretty pooped. Slightly shorter stream. I've got some shifts in my schedule coming up in another couple weeks, so I might be able to do some alternate time slot streams. Start earlier in the day on the Pacific coast here, so folks around the world, you might not normally get to watch me live. There's the Diablo 4 early access beta test on the 17th, 18th, and 19th. I'm probably gonna be doing that on that Sunday of that weekend to play for quite some time. They've got some special rewards for players that like hit level 20. Because during the beta test, you can only get up to level 25, and it's only for the first like zone or something. So I thought that could be fun. I'd probably still be playing it by myself on like Friday night and here and there on Saturday. But then I figured maybe Sunday I could like buckle down and just like do that. Thought that could be fun. Assuming I'm allowed to stream it, I actually don't know. I'll have to check. Anyways, thank you guys for hanging out, showing up late. Appreciate it. I'll be back tomorrow night. I'm gonna play some Marvel Snap, and I'll be off on Thursday night. My wife surprised me with tickets to a Kavinsky concert, so I'm doing that on Thursday night. Go listen to Kavinsky; he's awesome. And I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.